Hare Krishna. If we put gravity to test, gravity will put us to rest. Suppose somebody jumps down from a 10-story building and then they say, actually I'm testing whether gravity still works or not. They'll come down to a crash and they may break their limbs, they may even break their head, they may even lose their life. So at the they may be immobilized at the very least. So if we put gravity to test, gravity will put us to rest. Gravity is a law of nature and we need to recognize its power and harmonize ourselves with it, respect that power and not play with fire. So just as gravity is a law of nature, similarly there are subtler laws of nature which also affect us. There is the law of karma. There is the actions that we do, they will have reactions, they will have consequences, and we can't escape those consequences. If we think we can escape them, then we are an illusion. If we indulge in indiscriminately in sensuality, in immorality, then there'll be consequences to that. We are a part of a whole bigger than ourselves, and we need to live harmoniously with that whole. Just like if somebody tests the traffic rules, they will be, even if they are not immediately punished by the police, they may be punished by other drivers hitting them. They may eventually be caught once it becomes a habit for them. Even if somebody might escape from the traffic laws, we can't escape from the divine laws. The Bhagavad-Gita cautions us in 16:23 when it states, Yaha shastra vidhim utsrujya vartate kamakarataha nasa siddhim avapnoti nasukham naparamgatim. That if we reject the guidelines of scriptures which educate us in the laws that govern material existence and then help us to harmonize with those laws. If we neglect and reject these, then what will happen? And we think, I will just do whatever gives me enjoyment. Vartate kamakarataha. The result will be that we will be put to rest. We will not get anything worthwhile in life. Nasa siddhim avapnoti. Will not get the desired perfection, will not get happiness, nor will we get an elevated destination. The previous verses say that we may even go down to hellish destination. Trividam narkasyedam dwaram nashanam atmanah kamah krodhas atha lobhas tasmade tatrayam tejet. Therefore give up this. If we don't give up these anti-godly forces of lust, anger, greed, then they will take us to a hellish destination. So the more we live in harmony with scripture, the more we can be happy in this as well as future lives. So rather than putting gravity to test, we need to recognize the reality of gravity and live in harmony with it. And same principle applies also to the subtler laws of nature which represent ultimately the will of God. Thank you. Hare Krishna.